This time on Road and Race, we weigh our car cheaply. If you're like me and things like power to weight ratios interest you, you'll probably want to know how much your car weighs. Or if you've ever removed any parts or changed any parts, you'll probably want to know what a difference that's made. So the cheapest corner weight system I could find was about £800. And I thought that was a bit expensive, so I thought, is there a cheap way of doing this? So I had a quick look around and I found other people might have had some success with bathroom scales. Yes, bathroom scales. And they're very cheap, £10 each. So I thought, well, I'll give it a go. My car's handbook says my car weighs 13.75 kilos. So doing a bit of maths in my head, if each bathroom scale can take up to 180 kilos, then I'd need 8. So I popped down to my local supermarket and bought 10. Here's a summary of what we'll be doing. Lift one wheel, place the scales, place the wood, lower the wheel, repeat. These are the tools and parts you'll need. Jack, 10 bathroom scales rated to 180 kilos, wheel chocks, wood at least 50 millimeters thick. First, take a note of how much fuel is in the car. Here you'll see I've got about a quarter of a tank left. You'll need this to work out the final weight of the car. Next, remove anything you're not going to keep in the car. Here I've removed the spare wheel, toolkit and CD player. As for the wood, I picked up two 2.4 meter 2x5s from a local hardware store. These measure 47mm by 125mm. I made one cut at 900mm on each piece of wood to give me four pieces. Two of 900mm and two of 1500mm. Next, you'll need to lift one corner of the car. Please click on the screen now to refer to my lifting guide if you're not sure about this. Make sure the handbrake is on and lift the passenger side front wheel first. Place two scales under the wheel, then place a piece of wood on top. Slowly lower the wheel onto the wood. Place a chock in front of the wheel to stop the car rolling forward when you lift the rear. Repeat for the remaining wheels. If your car is light enough, in theory, that should be it. In reality, the rear of my Boxster is much heavier than the front due to the engine being there, and this would error the scales. To fix this, I use three scales each on the rear wheels. You'll have to experiment with the scales position as you need to spread the load evenly across them. Once you have all four wheels on scales and each scale giving you a reading, remove the chocks and simply write down the reading on each. You'll have to give each scale a quick nudge to get them to display the reading. So here are the results for my Boxster. The front driver's corner is 296.5 kilos. The front passenger is 270.2 kilos. The rear driver is 372.8 kilos. And the rear passenger, 386.3 kilos. This gives a subtotal of 1385.8 kilos. The wood weighed 11.8 kilos, so removing that, we have 1374 kilos. So let's talk about the weight of the fuel. From my research, petrol weighs 0.74 kilos a litre. My car has a 64 litre tank, so a quarter of that is 16, so fuel in the car weighs roughly 8 kilos. Without fuel, my car weighs 1,366 kilograms. This puts us in the middle of the weight range for this car given by the handbook. So whilst the bathroom scales may not be completely accurate, they are in at least the ballpark. I'll try to get the car on professional scales and see how accurate this is in the future. For those who are curious, the weight of the spare tyre is 12.1 kilograms. The toolkit and warning triangle is about 3.2 kilograms. And the CD player weighs just under 1.9 kilos. This makes a total of 17 kilograms. These are the final power to weight statistics for all those interested. You'll notice that removing the 17 kilos of weight from the car is the equivalent of an extra 2 brake horsepower per ton. If you found this video useful, please subscribe and hit the like button, as this helps us make more shows. If you have any questions about this show or suggestions for future shows, please leave a comment. You can follow us on our website, Facebook and Twitter. Click the screen now to watch our next video in this series. Thanks for watching.